Boldly.
Declared one of the best live bands on the planet, the Hives have been dominating the music world for many years. With their punk rock sound and black and white outfits, one cannot help to admire and catch on to the Hives pretty quick. But how did they get from playing in a garage to being one of the most popular bands out there? It all started in 1993, located in a very small town in Fagersta, Sweden. The Hives, a growing garage band, would perform in bars, schools, basically anywhere they could. The band was originally brought together by the lead singer Pelle Almqvist and Niklas Arson. Howlin' Pelle Almqvist was born May 29, 1978, in Fagersta, Sweden. Pelle and Niklas' brilliant minds attracted the attention of promoter, manager, songwriter Randy Fitzsimmons that propelled the band to fame. But yet, Randy has never been seen, so some say he's fictional. Howlin' Pelle is best known for being wildly animated during live shows that put Pelle on the list of the 50 greatest frontmen of all time. Some antics include mixing with the crowd, climbing on amps and ladders, and saying ridiculous arrogant things between songs.
There's a heat wave sweeping through Europe! As you stand here in your rock club, there is a heat wave sweeping through Europe! The Hives are the reason!
Niklas Arson, being the oldest in the band, was born January 26, 1977, and is the brother of the lead singer of the Hives, Pelle. Playing nothing but Fender Telecaster guitars, Niklas is lead guitarist in the Hives. Niklas is also backup singer for the band as well. One of many crazy antics Niklas performs on stage is spinning his guitar with a strap over his shoulder. In one case, the guitar strap broke, sending the guitar flying off stage. Chris Dangerous, also known as Christian Gran, was born on the 12th of June, 1978, and is the drummer of the Hives. Chris used to play for another local band in Sweden called Bad Dreams Always. Gran is best known for his high-speed drumming and accuracy when performing, switching beats easily in songs. Dr. Matt Destruction, also known as Matthias Bernwall, is the bassist in the Hives. Matt almost always plays with a black and white Fender bass guitar. His simple playing on the bass may seem that Matt is the weakest in the band, but Matt sometimes switches out the more complex bass lines. Vigilante Karlstrom, playing backup guitar, was born in 1978. Vigilante started playing guitar at the age of 10, and was influenced by bands such as Sex Pistols, The Dead Kennedys, and Swedish punk bands. After playing anywhere they could in Fagersta, the Hives would retreat back to their home, Hives Manor, just a mile up the road from the local bar they first played at. Secluded from everywhere else, this is where the Hives would get their work done. Many bands crave attention. This one did not. In 1995, the band was signed by Pelle Almqvist to Sidekick Records, a subsidiary of the Swedish punk record label Burning Heart Records. In 1997, the release of their first album, Barely Legal, was put onto shelves, and their song AKA IDIOT, located on this album, became a smash hit.
AKA IDIOT was as kind of a breakthrough for us. Right when we finished, we played it a lot, just to hear it ourselves. Just because we liked playing it so much.
How's it going?
We felt like we had written the best song we had written.
This one is about me. It is called AKA IDIOT.
Yeah.
The Hives then released their second album, Veni Vidi Vicious, which in other words means I came, I saw, I conquered, a famous quote by Julius Caesar in April 2000 through Warner Music Group. This album yielded the singles Hate to Say I Told You So, Die Alright, and Main Offender. After seeing the video for Hate to Say I Told You So on German TV, Alan McGee decided to sign the Hives to his newly formed Poptones label. Poptones released the Best Of compilation, Your New Favorite Band, in 2001, which proved to be the breakthrough record, reaching number 7 in the UK album charts. Main Offender reached number 24, and I Hate to Say I Told You So reached number 23 on the UK singles charts. In 2002, 1 year after this album was released, the Hives performed Main Offender at the MTV Video Music Awards.